bar graph object shows a tag value filling up a column or a bar like a thermometer. As the tag value right here, usually on a PLC, changes, I'll change the tag to, oh, say 23. The graph reflects the result by filling up the bar. You can even set a target line and have the graph change color when that target's exceeded. This target is set at 75, so I'll change this value to a 80. And sure enough, the color of the fill changed as we exceeded that target. This is a simple, easy, intuitive way to display analog data like temperature, pressure, fluid or fill levels. Let's see how to set this up. Double-click or drag the bar graph object onto the screen. Or if you see one you like down here in the parts list window, you can drag that onto the screen and save yourself some time setting things up. If you want to set it up yourself, you can enable a label, which can be at the top or the bottom. You can do the alignment, font, all the usual things. You can show the dimensions, or not. If you do show them, you can specify where you want them to be located, how many divisions, and if you want tick numbers or not. You can set up a target line to be a fixed value. We'll use 75 in our example. Or you can have a tag determine where that target line is. That way the PLC can set the target line in real time as the process is running. Now a target of 75 doesn't make any sense in a range of 0 to almost 10,000, so let's change this to 100. So now we have a more appropriate graph. Now you can see on our graph and on our simulator, our range goes from 0 to 100, and our target line is set at 75. If you do set a target line, then you have the option of doing a change pattern. So the fill pattern right now is specified to be black. Let's make that this crosshatched pattern. And then when we cross our target value, let's make this change pattern to be black so it really catches the user's eye. You can set the style down here, fill up, fill down, fill from the left, fill from the right. We'll leave it with the fill up in our example. And of course, we need a tag. Let's have this bar graph monitor our temperature tag. Looks like we're good to go, so let's say OK. Resize the graph so it fits on the screen. Simulate it. Save the project. And up pops our simulator with our new bar graph. So again, this bar graph is monitoring this temperature tag, and it looks like we've set a target line at 75. So if we fill up our bar graph, let's say to 45, we see our crosshatched pattern. If the tag gets set to a value that exceeds our target line, remember our target was at 75, so let's say 76, then the graph changes color to alert the user that something's wrong. The color version is the exact same thing, except we have a lot more control over the target line colors and the colors we use for fill and change patterns. Let's have this bar graph change to red when we exceed the target line. Say OK and see what happens. Tell you what, before we do that, let's make this a little bit bigger so it's easier for us to see. There we go. Now, simulate, save the project. Up pops our simulated version of the 4-inch panel now. It's still the exact same thing, except a little more colorful. Filling with black early on. When we cross that target line, the whole thing turns to red to alert the user. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.